Bhatia coming with live to you for another video, which will cover a very important topic. And I'll be covering up a stock which is listed in India market called Ambika Cotton. If you can hear me, just type in yes, you can hear me. So at least I know that my sound is coming clear to you. And I will be covering a deep dive on Ambika Cotton, which is a stock which is listed in India. And I have been covering up in various platforms about that stock. And just a clear disclaimer, this stock is in my portfolio. So my views, which I'll be sharing here, will be biased. But what I'll be covering up here is a complete analysis of the stock, Ambika Cotton. And let's see whether the stock can double from here, where it stands from the technical point of view, what are the key fundamental aspects which I kind of really consider as a key outcome of that company, or key important pointers which I want to share, which can help you make the decision. But again, there's no recommendation which I'm giving you here. I'm just sharing the knowledge, and you can make your own best decision whether the stock is something you want to, you know, add it to your portfolio. So if you can hear me, please type yes, so that I know that you can hear me well before I proceed. I'll just give a minute and we'll get started. Can you hear me? Awesome, awesome. So let's get started with the analysis. Let's see whether we are there. So what we're going to cover, we are, if you want to connect with me, you can click on the link or, you know, sbhatia.co/bio, and you can follow me any of the channels like Twitter or Facebook. So you have all the details there. What we're going to be covering up is Ambika Cotton Mills technical and fundamental analysis, so that you get a complete view of the stock. And what we'll be seeing is, can the stock double from here? And what is the key technical indicators which are showing on the chart patterns as well? Okay, so let's go there and let me share my screen. 1 minute. Yeah, I think this is good enough. So you can see my screen here. What I want to show you first is, what is this stock? So Ambika Cotton Mills, as I mentioned to you, is a stock which is listed in India, and it is based out of Coimbatore. As you can see here, let me grab my pen so it's easier. So the company is based out of Coimbatore, southern part of India. And this company is leader in specifically in the hosiery, cotton yarn and weaving space. What is important is the product has 100% cotton yarn, one of the finest cottons they make, which are used in premium branded shirts, which basically are mainly export shirts, t-shirts. And globally, they have some really marquee clients, which has been there for with the company for a long, long time. And if I quickly go into the some of the details about the company history, so that you get a view on that, is this company has been in operation, and that is something key here. And the company has been in operation from 1988 and have 4 manufacturing plants situated in various parts of India, and total spindle capacity of over 1 lakh. Okay, that is 1 million. And they're kind of considered as one of the top players in especially the cotton suppliers for the quality shirt manufacturing around the world. And what their key niche is about the providing that yarn, and that is basically they have been pride themselves with zero complaints from the client and the raw material suppliers, which is fantastic. And I'll show you about the, and very important to note is that the company is made of the leader, and the leader is really, really something very humble, down to earth. And I heard that the company director, or the person who is in helm of this company, also uses houses as a office space so that he can save cost. To that level of humbleness he is. And they also have their own clean wind power, so which they generate for their windmill. So basically they have the wind power, so that way they are also kind of ESG compliant as we go into ESG compliance going forward. So on and all, the company has been in business from several from 1988. So obviously they have seen all their all the cycles. So now let's go into some of the details about the company. The company is The company market cap is around 12,000 crores. So if you see, that is 12,058 crores. Stock P is still very cheap, which is like 9.58. ROC is high teens, which is 17%, which is great. ROE is also fantastic, 12.7, which is fantastic. So current market price is 2,200. It's run up a bit, but let's go through. The dividend yield is coming around 1.59 with this current price. But still, as you can see, this is a screener.in, which is a great website for looking the fundamental and the technical details, especially the, some of the chartings. But the intrinsic value is still being calculated as 2,500. Okay. Which is not bad. Let's moving on. Some of the pros. Clear this up. So company has definitely reduced their debt. Almost debt free, so there's no debt at all. Company is expecting a great to give a good quarters because they got a healthy exports going on, plus there's a tailwind from the government with the new PLI scheme, and they're giving a good dividend payout of 24.39. and I'll show you how the company owner, the person who is been in charge of the company, has been only living on dividends basically, and the family members also are very modest, and they're taking very modest salary and just working with as a dividend as their main income source from the company. So let's clear this. As you can see here, some of the competitors or the peer comparisons of still comes as one of the cheapest in the space of 9.58. And others, as you say, Vardhman Textile, Indocount, Arvind Mills, Nitin Spinners, Satluj, Ambika, and RSWM Limited. And if you look at their PE, this stock is still trading cheap. I wouldn't go into detail of all the financial matters, but I just want to cover up the key pointers, and I want to take you through some of the technical aspects of it. As you can see here, some of the sales, very important is to see the sales figures. There, if you just focus on the sales, let's try and grab this. This always goes in, yeah. If you can see here, their sales figures have been, you know, year on year growing, which is a good sign. And recently they have actually had a highest sales figure till last 12 months, trailing 12 months. and also operating profit has been also has been fantastic. So the tax, they have been regularly paying tax, which is great. They look at the EPS. This is the number. So, and that tells the story. Their earning per share has gone up from 31, which was in March 2010, to now 229. So if you have one share of this company, basically every share the company has earning of 229. Okay. And that tells the story why the stock has been doing so well, because their EPS has almost, you know, almost doubled. It's gone. Yeah, from 62. Oh, so sorry, I was looking at the wrong number here. This is Ambika Cotton. Yeah. So EPS has gone from 28, that is quarterly. And let's look at the profit. Yeah, from 31 rupees to 229. But look at the March quarter, it was 118, and today sitting at 229. So these are some numbers of compounded profit growth rates, and expected it's going to be doing a almost a double digit growth coming quarters. The share capital has been constant, which means the company is able to generate enough cash, and most importantly the reserves. So the reserves have been growing from 138 crores. So today the reserve is sitting at 641 crores, and their borrowings have been zero. So there's no borrowing, so there's no liability of the company. So that means the company cannot go bust, because they are able to generate enough cash to, and also have the, you know, reserves generated. So that tells the swell in the EPS as well. And they have done recent investments on their, if you look at it, their building machineries and also they have done a lot of plant machineries, have been upgraded themselves. They've added some new spindles. They've added some new lines for knitting, which is fantastic. So at least that that will definitely add up to the revenue going forward. So in and all, the company is fantastic. And look at this, how well the company is doing tells you from this number itself, their debtor days. Now, what is debtor days? This tells you how soon the company can receive back his dues. They're able to get back their dues from their clients in 8 days. Basically, people are basically waiting on a queue to get their product and probably paying them in advance for their product. That shows their product, how good their products are. And also important is return on capital employed, which basically tells you whatever the capital they have and whatever the, whether it's a debt or whatever the investments they make on their, in terms of the machinery plant, they're able to generate double digit. And if they're able to generate double digit return in today's world, that is absolutely phenomenal, because at the end of the day, you are able to beat what is the risk capital, or basically a risk rate of return, which is anything above 15% is considered fantastic. So with the shareholding pattern also is important. The promoter is have been buying shares. If you go and check there, when the stock price went down almost 700 or 800 or 900 rupees, Indian rupees, the promoter was buying. So they know better than anybody else. And if you follow the promoter and you understand the company and the business model, you will tend to benefit from that. So FIIs have completely kind of they've increased the stake a bit. They've almost exited. Now they increase the stake. So there has been a slight addition. And DIs also are kind of very minimal, mostly with the public. So it's promoter and the public which are holding it. Because it's a low liquid stock also, that could be one of the reasons that they will not be able to get too much of pie. So ValueQuest, India Mode Fund, has been investor for this particular company for a long time. So let's quickly go through the chart pattern now. Okay. Type in the comment box below so that you, if you have any questions, I can answer that along the way. Awesome. So let's look at a quick technical analysis, which will give you a perspective. What did we talked about? So let's try and do that. So last time when I was, I shared this view on Ambika Cotton was in month of July 15, right? And let's see what we anticipated in this, right? Yeah. So I said strong weekly close, averaging up because I was already holding up on this level, and updated chart, no question with the group, sectors moving in a favorable zone. That time there was no PLS scheme, but there was a sector, it was moving in a right direction. So there was a lot of pent up demand because of COVID. Hence the there was an export, and I think I had some discussions with some of my network and people who already know this company and this sector, and I started adding up. As you can see, this was a trend line. It was following very nicely, and so on a weekly chart, and stock gave a nice breakout. And that's the time when I shared here on public forum that this is the time to latch on. That was around 1400. Now, since then, the stock has, if you take that lowest number, 1400 sitting at, it went all the way to 2337, and now it's closed at 2200. So the stock has given a phenomenal return, almost close to 1,000 rupees, which is a great return given from July onwards, right? In between, there was a bit of a correction here, which basically nothing but the weak hands shaken out, and then now the next leg of rally is going in. And thereafter, I made another post, which was exactly at this trend line. You can see here, there was a stock made a high of lifetime high of 1840. Okay. And I was waiting on it. That's why you can see at this point, we were expecting some correction. And that exactly happened as per the plan. This was the period where it was kind of, you know, because if you see in the previous instance, the stock has let's do that. Let me clear it. Yeah, the stock did an all-time high, and when it broke this all-time high, it went all the way up, and then it didn't sustain, it corrected. But as you can see, there's a kind of a pin bar or kind of near doji was formed. And that was telling me that their selling is over, and now you expect some buying coming in. And I waited for the next. This is a weekly calendar, weekly candle. So obviously, if you look at it in more closely, in, let me zoom in. So you see, it went in into correction mode for three weeks. Then there was a kind of a near doji formed. And next three candles after that was kind of sideways, but never ever broke this doji, which is for me is a good sign. If you look at it here, this level becomes a crucial level for this particular stock, 1739. And if it breaks below that, if closes below that on weekly closing basis or monthly closing basis, I think the stock will become weak, according to me. And then now there has been a buying coming here, and stock should first, you know, take out its all-time high and then should take up. That's what I can see here from the chart. So look at the let's look at so if you look at the RS Nifty, which is a basically relative sense from the Nifty, it has been outperforming Nifty for some time now, and ever since it broke this consolidation zone, since then it has been in positive territory, and it has been performing better than Nifty. So if you have invested in this stock, you would have done better than Nifty. Is that what it means? And RSI is also showing that it is on the good territory where there is, it is above 50 and close to 70. So every time it goes and touch around 80, 85, there's a bit of a correction, as you can see from history. So you have to be careful from that point of view. If you can see here, every time it has come in, it was in this period, and this period. Every time it has come and touch here, 85 is RSI, there's a bit of a correction here. So please make note of it. And that is something you can book some profit here. But that doesn't mean that you need to exit, but you have to just be cautious. So what it means, let's take a monthly chart, because if you're looking for long term, you always have to look at monthly chart, right? And this, and since you're looking, when we're looking for the data from historical, you always turn the log chart on to get a clear perspective, because log chart will basically give you a clear view in terms of the percentage wise increase, not by the absolute terms. But if you remove the log chart, then you will definitely, you know, not know the exact impact of it. As you can see here, this rally from here, it seems to be a big rally, but if you put the log chart on, it is a normal, because you already had a big rally in the July 2009 until October 2010. So it is still smaller than, because it's in percentage term. The stock went from 36 all the way to 291. Okay. And here, and the stock from 385, it is almost going for 2,300. So you always look at from that perspective. And there has been tremendous volume going on, which you can see here. Look at the volumes here. It's almost close to lifetime high volume. So which is a, also looks like this, it is, stock has gone into strong hands. And now let's look at some of the key levels. If I were to plot, and let me remove the log chart, and let's take this low. Yeah. So I want to see what are the key levels, okay, for this stock. Let's try to do that. I will take this line and try and connect this. So you can take this high or that high, both are the same, doesn't matter, but this is a kind of a trend line which stock is in, right? If you do the left, that will not work. Yeah, that's fine. So that's one. Let's take the another trend line here, which also will give you some perspective, which is, yeah. So we take this trend line. So these are some of the swing highs on the monthly chart. Okay. And let's bring it down. So we are trying to gauge what could be the area where we have to take some money off the table. And then, so the immediate target, as you can see, is around 2,700. And then it can go up to 3,000, where you can see some resistance coming through. But given that it is, has been consolidating nicely above this all-time high, the highly likely, and we all deal with the probabilities, highly likely the chances are the stock will, you know, be trending up, and given the volume, so it is indicative of that stock will go up. So let's try and take some view on from Fibonacci based extension. So let's take a swing low, which could be, let's take the log chart on an auto. Yeah. Let's take this. So it is a 3-pointer take here and swing high, swing low, and remove the log chart and see what comes in. So as you see here, from the Fibonacci base extension also tells us the, some of the key levels. Okay. So first key level is already one, first one level, which is 2107, which is, I think, has been, you know, consolidating around this. Now next is where is indicative is the 3000. Let me So this is at 3,169. So if stock is going up, this is where you see that this is the next target as per the Fibonacci extension. But you will have a little bit of resistance around these trend lines. And once it going up and around this, so it kind of coincide here a bit. So that's your first target. But if you go further up, then thereafter 2.618 is around 4,887 is the next level. So with Fibonacci extension, you're getting higher levels. Let's see how it goes. But these are my immediate targets, which are I'm working with. This is what I wanted to share with you today. Hope it was useful and give you some insight about some of the key levels for Ambika Cotton, and also shared some fundamental view. Just type in the comment box below what was your key takeaway or any other points which I missed out. I'm happy to share that. And if you want me to cover any specific stock, please type in the comment box below so I can, you know, make the video on that as well. Till next video.